This week, we're going up against Lou Nasti, who's a mechanical engineer and an animatronics expert who does, like, all the big department store windows. He's a modern-day Geppetto, and he's been doing this for longer than I've been alive.
What's the challenge? What are we working on here?
The challenge is Santa's workshop. The special skill set is storytelling.
Santa's workshop, you think of building toys, stuff like that.
We're gonna make the North Pole Carlos Bakery Edition. It's gonna feature a huge storefront with a rolling conveyor belt manned by Santa's elves.
Then the unfinished cakes come through here. I'm gonna say Mo will be inside.
Okay.
And they get swapped out for finished ones that go out there.
Unfinished cakes will go into the machine called Elf-O-Matic, and then boom, they're gonna come out magically decorated. Why don't you three go start in the construction of it?
Okay.
Me and Anna will start making the cakes. All right, and then you jump in on the elves.
Deal?
Sure.
Let's do it.
Steven and Jose have to complete the structure of the shop. I've never built a display this quickly. My job as the animator is to make things look alive. I am gonna start with the elves. I'm gonna have elves working on a drill press, sawing wood, sanding and cleaning everything, and painting at the same time. I need to just do the linkage on this now. I made the motor mount and I did the paint to hold the figure. Best quality. My mechanical figures move with electricity. I can make things go back and forth, up and down, left to right. I can make things bow. And that by connecting different motors and different parts together, I can make many different movements. I think one of the things that's unique about what I do is that not many people do this. Animation is not something you go to school to learn. It's sort of a passion. Okay. At a very young age, I was able to build a robot. And it was a big robot, 6 foot. And I wound up on the front page of the New York Times. And it changed my life. I realized at that point, I did have a talent for this type of work. Keep it going. Quick, 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 knock it out.
Working with Lou is very fast paced.
Major Joe, you want to start the cake?
Do I do the cake or should I start painting toys? No sooner am I done with one project, or not even done, and he's got another one ready.
The toy's a secondary little prop, but if we start the cakes, it's gotta dry. I decided to give Buddy a little run for his money by making a figure with a cake. We're gonna use my face. What a beautiful face. With the cake, bravo. You have to put these lights right around here, too. Go right around the edge.
Okay.
It's gotta look like a buddy cake. You wouldn't wanna eat this one,
ready
though.
For competition.
Okay, thanks, kiddo.
All right. Rosie, my cake is baked.
It's baked.
Now I'm
That's
icing
quicker
it.
Quicker than Buddy.
There's not an exact science to mixing the buttercream color to make it exactly what you want.
The sound that mixer makes sounds like suspense violins in a movie. You know, like if someone was walking down a scary hallway and the van was like, nah.
I really want to make sure that we nail color all the time. I'm making a Christmassy sagey green, and took me a couple trial and errors. I was at this, but this is where I want to be. But the trick is you have to aerate your buttercream to get it nice and smooth.
I'm just trying to get this linkage lock connected so I can get them moving. And if these pivot points aren't perfectly parallel and lined up, they'll jam up and that's it. You're in trouble. The challenge of building a mechanical talking reindeer is that everything has to line up because of the linkage of the draw arms and the pivot points. And I'm doing it quickly. So I'm able to lift him up and down and then look left and right, and then I'll be able to make his head turn. So he'll be really animated. So 90% of this is bolted together and locked. And when I lock it with the quarter-inch hardware, it's not gonna move. These are the control wires that run the motors. The color codes are very important because it'll just create a problem with the direction of the motor. The motor moves it back and forth and gives me the movement I want. Typically, I build an animation, I test it for at least a week. I don't want it to squeak. I don't want anything to loosen up. I don't want anything to break. A small screw loosened because I didn't tighten it. can make the head fall off. When I connect it to the controller, it'll give me two movements at one time, so I can get, almost he's looking all over the place, because he'll go left, right, up, down, left, right, up, down.
In order to make it look like this elf is really on his phone, I found some of these little color-changing lights, and I popped a few of them into his hands so you get a reflection of, like, the screen light on his shirt. I messed up because I made it like a chat screen instead of a video. This elf is kind of the slacker. I've intentionally made his elf hat look a little more like a dunce cap. That's visual storytelling.
Jason Chatfield and Courtney Quinn aren't gonna be the perfect judges for this competition. Courtney Quinn is a color expert. If there's one thing you can't be for Courtney, it's bland. But I ain't a bland guy, so I ain't worried. Jason Chatfield is a cartoonist and a comedian based in New York City. Jason's work has been published everywhere, from The New Yorker to Mad Magazine.
Team Buddy, Team Lou, the theme of this challenge was Santa's Workshop.
And we're really excited to see the finished work. Lou.
Nope.
All right, Lou, let's see your creation.
Well, I think I've accomplished a lot. Let's take a look at what I've done.
Oh, my God.
My elves are busy working to complete the toys.
Bravo.
Nice. Gorgeous. Nice work, guys.
And then my talking reindeer.
There's so much going on.
I know. I feel like I have to look at it inch by inch because there's so much packed in there.
Yeah, I mean, we asked for a story, but this is a book.
Hello, Bingo.
Hey, Lou and Team Nasti. Bingo's my name and flying's my game.
Oh.
I fly the elves back and forth every day from their homes to the workshop and back again, sort of like the North Pole taxi service.
You like the job?
I sometimes get paid in gumdrops or cake from Buddy and his elves.
Who says the gig economy's dead?
Right.
Wow.
I gotta say, Lou, just looking at what you created, I could tell how much you love Christmas. I could tell how much you're in the business of making people happy. I gotta tip my hat and say bravo.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right, Team Buddy, show us what you made.
You got it. This year, Santa's kicking it Hoboken style, baby.
Wow.
Going against Lou and his team, we wanted to have a lot of movement.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Gears and gizmos and smoke and lights. The Elf-O-Matic 4000.
Elf-O-Matic 4000.
Is this patented?
Patent pending, made in Hoboken.
Wow. So did you build us a cake that makes cake?
That's exactly, Corny, what we did. We made you a cake that makes cakes.
Wow. That's the best kind of cake.
I'd really like to have a piece of any one of those cakes.
Team Buddy, Team Lou, the challenge was to create something that told the story of Santa's workshop.
Buddy, I love that you had the smoke coming out, you had the music, you had the whole scene come together.
There were a few details that I thought could have been just a little bit cleaner.
Thank you.
Lou, you created something so magical that really feels like Christmas.
But I feel like there was just so much going on that I didn't know where to look, and I wanted it to kind of flow a bit easier. You've both done an incredible job, and you've given us a really difficult job. But we do have to choose a winner.
When I see Buddy's display, okay, it's nice, but I don't think it can pass the mine. It doesn't have the sophistication. But I'm not working with chocolate and icing and cookies. I'm working with steel. There's an edge on my side, but you never know.
I mean, listen, looking at both pieces, it's anybody's game, you know? And listen, if you're gonna lose to a guy that does Christmas for a living, it's okay.
The team that conquered Christmas is... Team Buddy!
Yay!
Congratulations, Buddy. Your prize of $5,000 will be donated to the St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital.